Let's get more on those explosive allegations revealed by 60 Minutes, The Age and the Sydney Morning Herald that a Chinese spy ring tried to plant an agent for Beijing as an MP in Australia's federal parliament.
Well, this isn't just cash in a bag, given for favours. This is a state-sponsored attempt to infiltrate our parliament using an Australian citizen and basically run them as an agent of foreign influence in our democratic system.
Imagine the consequence of a spy betraying the organisation. I know very well that the Chinese Communist Party can never be trusted. Once I go back, I will be dead.
Let's go to Canberra now for more on this with Nine's political editor, Chris Yuleman. Chris, morning to you. Extraordinary development here because ASIO's Director General of Security, Mike Burgess, he has now put out a statement saying they're taking these allegations very seriously. I mean, it's very rare that you have the spy agency come out and declare its hand on something.
Tom, I have the press release here, and up in the corner you can see that it says that ASIO is 70 years old. You could count on the fingers of one hand the number of times that ASIO in that time has put out a statement on any media story, and that includes the Petrov affair if you go back all that way. So it is highly unusual for the spy agency to put out a press release, and as you say, it says it takes the allegations seriously. It goes on to say that it was previously aware of the matters that have been reported today and has been actively investigating them. So essentially, the story that 60 Minutes brought us last night did shine a light in a very dark place, and it's a place where our security agency is already investigating.
Well, often with ASIO, they try and do their work in the background. Is this essentially a shot across the bows of China to say, look, we're onto you?
Oh, Tom, I think that there has been a change of attitude by some of the security agencies. They also understand now that they are in an information war, and on occasions they have rarely fired a shot. And the other side is certainly particularly active. You know, the Chinese government essentially controls the editorial line of almost every Mandarin language outlet in Australia. So there is a reason why the agencies themselves might want now to be a bit more on the front foot and to be saying that they are aware of these things and that they are a threat to our democracy.
Well, this is always the delicate tightrope that Australia walks. On the one hand, China is such a vital trading partner for our country, but on the other hand, there is this challenge to democracy. At what point do you think things will really sway and Australia has to start weighing up the benefits of dealing with this country?
We're in that position right now, Tom, and we have been in that position for some time, that Australia, for the first time in its history, has a major trading partner that's not a liberal democracy, and it is a strategic rival of our major ally, the United States. The United States has pressed back very hard against China, and it's not just the president. It's right across all of the Democrats and Republicans in Congress in the United States now believe that China is their major strategic threat. So it's going to be a difficult time for Australia in the years ahead. It's a difficult balancing act. But this idea that we need to develop a position of trust with China, a scholar once said to me, he was a Russian and China scholar, who said, look, I don't know why we have to have a relationship of trust. Russia and China understand each other perfectly and they don't trust each other at all.
Well, let's get back to this this case that was raised on 60 Minutes last night. A fascinating story, this one. Where do you think that investigation goes in terms of the role that China tried to play in terms of getting a pawn, effectively, in our parliament?
Well, there's been a suspicious death, so there will be a coroner's inquest and we'll see what that does throw up. And the investigation, obviously, will look at all the different aspects of this. But the thing that's not unusual about this is that people are trying to influence politics in Australia. Now, we have evidence of that going back over years, and it's mostly been via political donations. We also have evidence of people in local councils who appear to be positioning themselves for a career in politics. And again, there's been a light shone on that as we look at what's happened in New South Wales with the ICAC investigation. So across a whole lot of fronts in Australia, for quite some time now, the Chinese Communist Party, I should say, has been very active, and our intelligence agencies are well aware that there is a genuine threat there.
Chris, always great to get your expertise and analysis on these issues. Appreciate your time this morning. Definitely.